Trilithic is introducing its new digital leakage equipment, the Seeker D, and also the MCA3 and the CT4 channel tagger. When we built this equipment, we were trying to provide a solution for really two issues. One, in an all-digital plant, I don't have the traditional analog carrier that I can lock onto with my analog leakage gear. And two, I realized that I have to monitor a much higher frequency up near where the cell phones operate. Cable companies, if they have leaks in those frequencies, can cause interference with cell phone operation. The Seeker D allows you to monitor both frequencies in the same ride out. In other words, I can patrol for leakage in the aeronautical band, and I can also patrol for leakage at a much higher frequency range where the cell phones operate. The way we do this is we switch rapidly back and forth between the two frequencies, quickly enough that we can monitor both very well in one ride out, but also slowly enough so that we can tune to each individual frequency and detect any energy that's there. The MCA3 is part of this system, as well as the CT4 channel tagger. The channel tagger will be required with the Seeker digital system. Also, this equipment is completely compatible with the leakage analysis workshop software, the LAW server software, if you have it. In other words, if I've got several Seekers right now with the LAW software and it's up and running fine, I don't have to completely replace all my Seekers. I can add on a couple Seeker Ds if I will, and they'll be able to upload to the LAW server just like my analog Seekers will. So I can have a mixed platform. This will require an upgrade to the LAW software, but it's otherwise completely compatible. Trilithic has provided a solution for digital leakage that's really one of the more economical out there, and it adapts well with the existing product that our customers are already using. Those of you that have used our Seeker analog leakage detector will notice that the Seeker D looks much the same. It actually acts the same in a lot of ways. The layout is similar, the power button, the snapshot key, the way I navigate through the menus is the same. You'll notice I can now tune to the higher frequency range as well as the aircraft band. I can set this thing to monitor the traditional bandwidth, the aircraft band. I can set it to monitor the higher frequencies where the cell phones operate, or I can set it to monitor both. In handheld mode, there are two different antennas, the analog rubber duck antenna and then the higher frequency rubber duck antenna, if you will, depending upon what specific frequency you're using when you're trying to walk the plant out and find that actual leak. Otherwise, it acts and operates essentially the same as the Seeker that you're using now or that you're most familiar with.